In this demonstration, we're going to build a class that implements three interfaces: countable, array access, and iterator aggregate. The movie catalog class is a class that stores our list of movies and provides an interface for the user to be able to interact with that list of movies, either to insert movies or to retrieve the movies that are stored in the object. So the first thing we do on line three is read in our configuration file. In the configuration file, we've got our application configuration information for our databases, which we are not using in this demonstration, our debug control configuration setting, and the application's root directory setting. When needed within the application, can be read directly from the configuration file. From a design standpoint, putting all of the configuration information external to the application code makes configuring the application very flexible. If I want to change the database that I'm connected to, if I want to change the user for the database, I can do that without changing any code within the application. This is important because in a production system, any code changes have to go through a process for testing quality assurance before it's put on the production machine. If we can change the configuration of the system without actually changing any code, we can eliminate the steps of testing and quality assurance when we need to reconfigure the application. So as much of the configuration information that we need for the application that can be put into an external file, the better and more flexible our application will be. So back to our class, I've read the configuration file on line three. On line four, I read the debug section of the configuration file and the debug on value and assign that to my global debug variable. I'm going to use that to control the scaffolding in my code. Then on line six, I declare the class movie catalog. And notice the keyword implements. Class movie catalog implements, and then the comma separated list of the interfaces that we are implementing in this class. Then on line eight, I have a private array variable called movies. This is going to be what stores our movies. And then the constructor. In this case, on line nine, the construct method doesn't do anything to initialize the object. So what we've done is put some scaffolding code in the construct function to demonstrate the magic constants that are available to us from the PHP environment. In this case, I'm using the file, the class, and the method magic constants. And I'm just printing out which file we're in, what class we're in, and what method we're in when the constructor is called. Then on line 20, the countable interface has a single function called count. And because we're implementing the countable interface, we must provide a definition for this function, and we do. The definition is simply to return the number of movies that we're storing in the movies array. And we do this by calling the count function and passing it the class variable movies. Then on line 25, we begin the implementation of the array access interface functions. On line 29, offset get function accepts a parameter identifying the index of the array that we want to return. We test to ensure that an element actually does exist at that index, and if it does, we return that element, otherwise we return false. On line 37, we can set an element of the array. This function offsetSet takes two parameters, the index and the value to be placed at that index. Now in this case, if we don't provide an index, then the value will be assigned to the array at the next available index. So the if statement on line 39 tests if there is an index value that was passed in. If so, then we assign the value that was passed in to that index. Otherwise, on line 45, we assign the value that was passed in to the next available index in the array movies. Then we return true on line 47. One of the functions in the array access interface that we must implement is offset unset, which takes a parameter identifying the index of the array that the user wants to delete. On line 51, we call unset on the movies array, passing the value of the index that was passed in as a parameter. This essentially deletes that element from the array, and then we return true. In the implementation of the iterator aggregate interface function getIterator, we're simply creating a new object of type arrayIterator and initializing that object with the class array variable movies. That's going to return an object of type arrayIterator that can be used in the for each loop. On line 60, we've defined a function insertMovie that takes a movie object as a parameter. And then notice on line 62 that we are calling the array access interface method offsetSet, passing it an index and the movie object to insert into the array for us. And recall again on line 62 that an array is zero based. Therefore, the count of elements in the array will always be one more than the last indexed value in the array. So we can simply use the call to the count function to get the index at which to insert the movie object that's passed as a parameter. Then another method on line 64, where we're going to allow the user to search for movies by director name. So this function takes a single argument, the name of the director. Then we use a for each loop to iterate over our class array movies and test the value of director. If they are equal, then we display the movie information. So our movie class then is a simple data class. It has four private variables, the title of the movie, the director, the year it was released, and the rating of the movie. The constructor on line 83 takes four values identifying the movie, title, director, year, and rating, and assigns those to the class variables. We do some conversion on line 85 through 88 of the case of the values passed to the function. On line 85 and 86, we call string to lower to convert the values of the title and director parameter to all lowercase, and then call UC words, which converts the first letter of each word to uppercase. And then on line 88, we convert the rating parameter to uppercase. On line 90, we've defined a display function that provides a formatted output of the private data that's stored in the class. On line 94 through 109, we have a set of get functions to individually return the values of the internal class variables. That's the interface for the user to interact with this movie class, and it is this movie class that we're storing in our movie catalog. The movie catalog has an array of movies, and that array is going to store objects of type movie.